watching from the windows. All those years outside looking in. All that time, never even knowing just how blind I've been. Now I'm here, blinking in the starlight. Now I'm here, suddenly.
Chasing down a daydream. All those years living in a blur. All that time never truly seeing things the way they were. Now she's here, shining in the starlight. Now she's here, suddenly I know. If she's here, it's crystal clear. I'm where I'm meant to go. At last I see the light, and it's like the fog is lifted. And at last I see the light,
and it's like the sky is new.
And it's warm and real and bright, and the world is somehow shifted.
The edge of the water, long as I can remember, never really knowing why. I wish I could be the perfect daughter, but I come back to the water, no matter how hard I try. Every turn I take, every trail I track, every path I make, every road leads back to the place I know, where I cannot. Yeah.
can see her eyes looking from the page of a magazine. She makes me feel like I could be a tower, big sun tower, the power to be, the power to give, the power to see, yeah, yeah.
Suddenly I see.
She got the power to be, the power to give, the power to see, yeah, yeah.
Suddenly I see.
She got the power to be, the power to give, the power to see, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Suddenly I see.
She got the power to be, the power to give, the power to see, yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
know the tears are rolling down your face, and it feels like yours was the only heart to break. When you come back home and all the lights are out, and you're getting used to no one else being around. You.
Hey guys, it's so exciting for me to finally meet you for the very first time, and I just want to start off by saying that if you are watching this live stream right now, congratulations, because I think that you have made a really brave choice by joining us today and by joining the online class. I know some of you might find this a new challenge, you might not feel comfortable right away, but assure you, eventually you're going to find this to be an exciting experience, and you're still going to meet your new friends eventually. And I hope that in a very short time, all of us will be able to come back to the campus and that we can finally meet each other in person. So I'm going to be honest with you guys, these 3 years, it is going to be the best 3 years in your life. So some advice for you, just try to enjoy yourself here. University is not a place where you are fighting with each other. It is not a competition. Everybody should help out each other because we are all in this together, okay? We are in the same boat, and that is the boat that I'm talking about. So again, make new friends, find new hobby, and try to get some good grades so that when you look back 3 years later to this day, you're going to think that you have made one of the best choice in your lifetime. Okay, so let's get started. So I guess this might not be the kind of start of the university life that you kind of have on your mind. So right now everything is online, so you're actually doing all the program, all the subjects to a screen. So to me, it just doesn't feel organic, okay? So before we actually start, I'd like to bring you on a little tour to our campus, and I'll bring you to my office, exactly this location where I'm currently streaming from, just to give you a quick look on how beautiful our campus is, and hopefully in a really short time, all of us will be able to come back to the campus and that you can see for yourself how beautiful the campus is. Okay, now, if you're ready, come on, come along with me to a little journey and let me show you a whole new world. So let me tell you a little bit about myself. You know, I like to talk about myself. You can even see there's a picture of me in the slides. So I'm Dr. Ang, but most of the people here call me Avocado. Yeah, this avocado right here. So this video is not a technical lecture. We are not getting into lectures yet. It is just a warming video to welcome you to FICT and to this subject. So throughout the next 20 minutes, I'll be talking about me, myself, mostly, and also be talking about some of the important stuff that I think you should know about the subject. So I actually think that maybe I'm one of the most handsome lecturer in Utah. Or at least that's what I think, and I hope you can agree with me. And I can tell you it is even more true this semester, because this semester everything is online. So when you are online and when you're in, compared to a real person, it is a totally two different person. And I think you know that everybody looks way better in their own profile pictures compared to a photo where you're being tagged by your friends. So that's why I'm saying that I look even better online, because I can tell you most of the profile pictures that I have the courage to post my social media apps, I do some kind of engineering works to them, okay? If you know what I mean. So that explains why, if you look at my pictures here, it is so different from the one that you see on the Utah official website. But that's okay. So I just want to be honest with you on what you are seeing here. Everything is real, okay? There's no filter, there's no beauty face. What you see is what you get. And that's because I haven't managed to find a proper beauty face that works for the live streaming. I found a few, but they always come with all these funny ears or this UFO hat or this weird sunglasses. So I don't think it is suitable for streaming, which is why I'm still looking. And it is true, because you see, if I have any beauty face, I will look something like this, you know? So it is like way different, okay? So this is what I show on my profile pictures, okay? So this is what it looks like when you're being tagged by a friend. So I'm going to share a little bit of history on FICT. So actually I graduated here. I did my degree here in UNL, so technically I am also your senior. And then I went to finish my PhD in USM Penang, and now I'm back here to do this live stream with you. So what I can tell you as a Utahian is that things are getting better these days, okay? It really is. So back in my days, when I was doing my degree program, we are not here yet, we are back in the old campus in Kuala Lumpur. So during that time, we only have like 7 people, if I'm not wrong, in our class, you know, 7 people. And that's not the worst thing. The worst thing is that out of the 7 people, there's not even one girl. Not even one. Yeah, you heard me right. And now, why I'm saying things are getting better is because in FICT, you have more and more girls are joining us. So we are really lucky that people don't think IT is only for guy only, okay? Meaning only for alpha guy. So not anymore. Right now, I can tell you about the statistics. We have around 30% of girls to 70% of guy, okay? So of course, it is not ideal yet. We want to have 50-50 so everybody can have one girlfriend by the time you graduate, right? But we are not there yet. I hope one day we are going to get there. But I think it is a good sign, okay? So I hope this becomes one of the motivation for you to do well in FICT and in your degree. Now I'm going to answer some of the popular questions that new students normally would ask when they first join UTAC, okay? Especially for this subject. So I think the very first questions that everybody have on your mind right now would be, hey, how do I get an A for this subject without doing anything? Okay, now I can tell you that is not possible. Okay, because I'm not a magician, okay? I have an Apple Pencil here. I'm a lecturer, so this one is not the magic one that I can just point and then you get an A. It's not that simple, okay? So the advice would be you have to be consistent, have to work hard. So don't miss any of the class, and if you are joining all the classes, please don't mute. Please don't press the mute button, okay? Try to stay with us and try to follow the class, and that's how you will get an A. But of course, there's one other thing that you can actually do, okay? And that is to follow me on my Instagram, okay? So don't forget to follow me on my Insta. I'll tell you the reason why. So you're going to get all your study materials, including your slides, your lab manuals, from Weber, okay? That's cool. And with that, you have everything that you need to study. But if you follow me, it is a little bit different because you get to know what you need to study. So can you see the difference here? One is that you have everything that you need to study. And if you follow me, I post from time to time on my story, okay? So you get to know what you need to study, you know. This is all the things that you need to study. This is what you need to study. So you know what to do. It is up to you. Are you the kind of person who like to study hard? Or are you the kind of person who like to study smart? That's up to you, okay? So again, don't forget to follow me on my Instagram account here. I'm going to show the name tag in a short while. You can just scan and then you follow me, okay? I'm just kidding. So the first part about study hard, about having to join in a class, that's true. But on the part where you follow me on Instagram, that's optional, okay? But of course, I still hope that you follow me, huh? But it doesn't mean that you have to follow me to get an A, okay? It is all on you. Now, the next question that you might have on your mind would be, is this a really difficult subject? And is it easy for me to get an A for this subject? Because I think now you're in UCCN1004, so you, of course, you wish to have a good start. So, what I can tell you is that if I say that this is an easy subject, I'll be lying, okay? You'll find that data comm is not a subject that is easy, and it is just a walkover. And we have a really good reason for that. I'm going to explain that in a clip for you. So I'll play a clip for you right now. Now just think about this. If you are playing an online game right now, and somewhere in the middle, you got disconnected. So I think the very first reactions that we would have would be, hey, what is this? I pay so much money, and then I can't even play a proper game. Something like that is going to happen. So as you can tell, people have very high expectations on the internet. And to make sure the internet works properly from time to time, or most of the time, for us to do what we are trying to do on the internet, it requires a lot of work. So you might think like it is just like magic that it works, but actually behind the scene there is a lot of engineering stuff which are going on, and we are going to go deep into a lot of communication technology that make the internet that we have today a reality. Okay, so now by now you probably know that we have such a high expectation on the internet to work, which is why it is not easy to make everybody happy on the internet. Okay. So to answer my question, is this a hard subject? I would say that it is a manageable subject, but you really have to put in efforts. You really have to try to understand what's going on, try to get the concept and most of the intuition behind the concept of computer networking. And when you are going to the labs, make sure that you'll be able to follow everything that you are going to learn. You'll be progressive, meaning that it will be built. Lectures 2 will be building on Lectures 1, Lecture 3 will be building on Lectures 2. So if you do not have a good start and you don't have a good foundations, then you might find it challenging going forward in this subject. So just make sure from time to time you are able to, you are with us, you are synchronized with us. So, and if you do that, I can tell you it will be easy. Okay? The exam for this subject is not difficult, in fact it is easy. Okay? The hard part would be whether you can understand the computer network concepts, and once you get past that, everything will just fall right into place for you. Okay, so when I say easy, it could mean many things. Like if you are the kind of guy who really study and know your stuff, then it will be really easy. If you are those kind of people who are just hoping that maybe I have 5 slides and I only need 2 of the slides and hope that in the exam the question is coming from that 2 slides, then I can tell you the exam will be easy for me to mark. Okay, if you get what I mean. Okay, now to a more general questions about online learning. So if you are thinking that, or maybe you are still undecided, hey, should I be in this class right now? I'm not sure if I'm making the right choice. So I can tell you, since you're already here, just give yourself a chance. I am sure that you will find a way for things to work out. So don't worry about whether you'll be fit for online learning, whether you will be able to cope. So things like that, just put them aside first, but rather focus on what you need to learn and try to learn it in a fun way. And also at the same time, don't forget that although this is an online class, all of your friends are still in a live chat. So if you ever feel like you need to talk to somebody, go to that chat. You can talk about anything. It is not just related to datacom, but of course if you have any technical questions about the subject, please also ask on the chat as well. I'll try to reply to the chat every half an hour during our lectures break. And I'd like to add that in fact online class, you have there are good things to say about online class as well. And if you really need help, please don't forget, we are always here for you. Okay, I'm always here for you. And that brings me to the last part of the introduction. So I'm just going to say that you should always ask questions, okay? That's one way for you to learn and to really know whether you know your stuff. But I know you because you're Asian. I'm also Asian. And the thing about Asian is that we are always shy, you know. So sometimes when you have a question about a slide, you will be thinking about 100 million possibility. How should I ask this question? What's the best way for me to ask this question so that nobody is going to laugh at me? Okay, is this even a good question to ask? So things like that is going to go through our mind, okay? And in the end, you don't ask. So you find so many different ways to ask, but you didn't ask, okay? And the worst part is, what you didn't ask actually came up in the exam. So I know that this is a problem for Asians, but I cannot fix this now because yeah, I cannot make you an American just by using my magic wand, right? Anyway, so since you are shy, I'm going to create a platform for you to ask questions, okay? So there are two ways for the Q&A. Now, during the live lectures in the online class, we'll be using the apps called Slido. Now, for these apps, you'll be given a code. And using the code, you would be able to enter a chat room, okay? Now, you can post any kind of questions on the chat room. And during the half hour break within the lectures, I'm going to go to this Slido to check out all the questions and try to answer as many as I can. So that's Slido, okay? Now, another way would be, you can actually write me an email. So I'll give you a full list of way you can contact me over here. This table is showing you all the different kind of possible way you can reach me, and if you're still undecided on which to choose, there is actually a column that says what's the best way to reach me for different kind of reasons, okay? So you can get a screenshot of this screen, keep it for yourself, and you can stay in touch in any one of these platforms, okay? Now in these sections, I will be showing you where do you get your study materials and what is the best and the recommended way for you to approach this subject. Okay, now for the lectures, you're going to get two kind of video, okay? The first one, it is the pre-recorded lectures, and this are mostly short videos. For the pre-recorded lectures, it will be uploaded on YouTube before the lecture class. So it is recommended for you to click on the YouTube link and watch the video before coming to the lectures. Now the idea of the pre-recorded lectures is to give you an insight into what we'll be covering for the next lecture. Now the second kind of video is the lecture recording, which is exactly what you are seeing here. So by the end of this class, I'll be putting up this recording of the lectures onto another YouTube link. If at any point of time you think there is a need for you to replay the lectures, you can always click on the next YouTube link for the recorded lectures. Now both of the YouTube links will be posted on Webber, so you can just go to webber.com and you'll get all the YouTube links to all the videos right there, okay? So if you're that kind of person who are not really a visual learner, so you just feel more comfortable if you have something for you to read and that you can memorize because that's how you feel prepared for the exam, then the most suitable way for you to learn will be using the medium.com articles. So on medium.com, I have written a few articles about computer network, mostly on the concepts in length, meaning that each concept that I think is important for you to know has been elaborated in a way that you don't have to know anything before that. So it has been explained clearly with given examples, and in some of the articles you might also find short videos that are already embedded in the post to make you understand better. Okay, so that is Medium article. Now if you are asking, do I need to watch both the videos and also be reading the articles? Yes, you should. If In any of the lectures, you find that there are certain concepts that is confusing to you, try to look for a related Medium articles and go through the articles. With that, I'm sure you will understand the concept way better. Okay? Okay, now let's get to the part that everybody is waiting for, and I'll be showing you the marks allocation for this subject. Now this subject is a 50-50 subject where you'll be having 50% of coursework mark and 50% coming from your final assessment. For the 50% of the coursework, it has been listed in the table shown here. And for your information, all the assessment for this trimester will be fully online, and that includes the online quiz, online midterm test, and 2 online practical tests. If you have any further questions about the exam format, please feel free to write to me and I'll be happy to tell you more about them. So everything good about Datacom that you had heard of is coming from me. And right now, let us hear directly from some of your seniors and let's hear what they have to say about Datacom.
Hi, Aaron Malk here, Year 2 Communication and Networking student. Here's my 2 cents on Datacom and why you should learn. So basically, everyone's using the internet nowadays, right? But nobody really knows what's going on behind the scenes and how the internet works. And this is where Datacom comes in and teaches you on how the internet works, how data transferring works, and so on. So if you're interested in the internet and networking, and you want to know why your videos are always buffering, why your message is sending so slow, pick up the subject and you'll know why. It's really fun. It may be challenging sometimes, but I promise you, it's really worth it. So it's also part of fun. No? So what are you waiting for? If you get a chance, pick it up.
So basically what you will learn from this subject, Datacom, is the first part will be the physical part, which is the hardware you get introduced to, such as router, hub, and how a PC communicate with another PCs. You'll eventually know all these specific terms I mentioned above when you go through it. And the second part, you get to learn how to configure a network visually using a software called Cisco Packet Tracer, if I'm not mistaken. Don't worry, your lecturer will guide you using this software. And there's a little calculation you need to learn in this subject, such as calculating the IP address, subnet mask, and for card mask. But don't worry, it's just very basic math calculation only. If you are a CN student, this will be a kickstart for you, as this subject will serve as an intro about those networking stuff. But if you are not, this subject will serve as a general knowledge about all those networking stuff. Like at least you have a basic knowledge about the configuration of network. Yeah.
Hello. 在 Data Communication and Networking 这个 course 里面学到两个不同的 device 怎样 communicate， 还有那个 data 怎样 across internet， 就好像你跟你朋友聊天，那个 data 怎样通过 internet 去到你朋友的电话。而这个 course 也会有一些算术，就好像用 subnet mask 来算你们的 network address， 还有算这个一个 network address 会有多少个 usable address。有了 IP address， 不同的 device 他们才能 communicate with each other。 然后你们在 practical 会学到怎样用一个 simulator 叫做 Cisco Packet Tracer 来 configure 这些 IP address 给不同的 devices， 好像电脑啊、 server 啊、 router。 Cisco Packet Tracer 也可以用来看你们的 packet 怎样 travel 从一个 devices 去到另外一个 devices。 然后你们在 practical 还会学到另外一个 software 叫做 Wireshark， 它是一个很 powerful 的 network analyzer， 所以它有它的好处还有它的坏处。 它的好处就是，如果你的 network 有问题，你可以用 Wireshark 来 troubleshoot 你的 network。它的坏处就是，如果有人滥用它 ，Wireshark 可以用来盗取一个人的个人资料，还有他的密码那些重要的东西。这个 course 基本上就是这样子，你们学到刚刚所说的那一些，然后读那个教书也是很好、很仔细。如果你们有专心听课，没有逃课，你们一定会考到你们理想要的成绩。
The mute button, where's the mute button on the YouTube player right now? I hope that you'll find what we have planned for you to be really interesting, and I can't wait to get started with you. Okay guys, can you hear me properly? Let's do a sound check first. Okay, so we're going to start with our first lecture start. Okay. So for the first lecture, we're going to start easy. So this lecture one is not a very technical lecture. It is just a basic intro to what is the internet is about. Okay, so on the first slides, you actually are currently looking at my girlfriend here, so Taylor Swift, and she is currently in New York, and I'm streaming right here to be with you from Kampa. So we actually having a long distance relationship, okay? But like what they say, the key to a healthy communication, to a healthy relationship is in communication, which is why this subject is so important. This subject we are learning about communication, okay? So for me and my girlfriend, we talk from time to time on Facebook Messenger. So although we are not actually together, but we still feel close to each other. Okay, so that is basically what the internet can do for us. Okay, so you know that with internet, you can reach anyone, anywhere easily. Okay, so I'll just check whether you can hear properly first. Okay. So in these lectures, that you don't have to worry too much about will it be out in an exam or stuff like that, because this is just the intro, okay? Now in this subject, for all the important stuff that you need to know, like what I promised you earlier, what all the things that you need to know to get an A, I will tell you in indirectly, I will tell you about that. So don't worry about whether this is important or not. Everything is important, but I will tell you what to focus, okay? So let's get back to the slides here. Now, for the internet, so we have been on the internet all this while. Like, we are streaming right now, we are streaming on YouTube for this lecture. So actually, that's because with the internet, we can do so. So Actually, the internet is a collection of all the end devices that are all connected together with networking devices. Okay, so I'm going to say this again. On the internet, if you ask what is it, what do we have on the internet, is actually all of the end devices. Okay, so end devices are the devices that you are using day to day to get online. So your phone, your laptop, your smart TV, all those are end devices. Okay, and all these devices, they have to be connected together. And they are connected together using networking devices. So some example of networking devices are routers, switches, and hubs, which are, I'm going to show you the real stuff later. In a short while, I will do an unboxing with you to show you the real router, real switches, and real hubs, okay? So basically, internet is just like that. You have networks, and then you have routers on the that connects all these networks together, okay? So to the next slide here. So now over here, you'll get a slide where it is asking us this question, how can we build the networks? So the simple answer here is, to build networks is actually not too difficult. We just need to find the best way to connect all the devices together. Okay, so what do we mean by the best way? It means all the different kind of networking technology that we have today. So you can connect devices together using internet connections. You can connect devices using 3G, 4G, or the 5G that are coming right now. Or most of you, you're using a laptop right now, you should be connected using a wireless connection. So let's say, for example, you can always, in this slide, all the box here, you can just imagine them as devices, okay? So technically, we call them a node. So all these things are called a node. So how do we connect nodes together to build networks? Now, of course, the simplest way or the most common way that we are using today is using the wired Ethernet connections. So let's say if you connect two devices together using a wired Ethernet, then they become a network. So this one, it forms a network here. Okay, so they become one network. Now, you can also connect devices using wireless connections, like maybe you're using a Wi-Fi connection to connect these two PC or these three PC together. So in that case, now these three of them, they are in their own network. Okay, so you can be building many different networks just by connecting end devices together. Okay. Now if you think that I'm speaking too fast, don't worry. You can always play back the video and then you put it to set half of the playback speed. Okay, then it won't be too fast for you lah. So let's go to the next slides here. In fact, there are two ways we can connect devices together. So you can either be using a wired connections or you're using a wireless connections. Okay, so I'm going to give you an example here. Over here, this is an Apple earpod. Okay, so this one is a wired connection. So when you want to listen to music, you're supposed to connect this one, this with wire one, to your phone. Then you can listen to music. Okay, now if I take a scissors, okay, and then I cut this wire together. So I have a scissors, I cut this wire away, I lose the cable, then it becomes an earpod. So this is a wireless connection. Okay, so a wired connections, this is a wired connections, and this is a wireless connection. Okay, now in fact, this one, you can see it is still new, it is still in the packaging. So I'm going to do a giveaway for this earpod. It's true one. So this one, later on, I'm going to do a giveaway on my Instagram, and whoever is lucky will get this, okay? Because I have too many earphones here already. Okay, yeah. So let's get back to the slides here. We talk about the wired connections first. I'll give you a few examples about wired connections. Okay, so the first kind of connections here that we use, the most commonly used wired connections, are called the Ethernet cable, okay? Now, the scientific name for this cable is an RJ45 cable. But when you go to the shop, when you want to buy a cable, the LAN cable, you will just say a LAN cable. You wouldn't say this is an RJ45 cable, okay? But anyway, just for you to know, this is called an RJ45 cable. So I have one cable here. Now, this is, I think everybody have seen this now, okay? This one is, we call this an Ethernet cable or a LAN cable. Okay, now if you are a CN student,
one day in one of the subjects, you will learn how to build this cable on your own. So you will have the chance to build your own cable, and then you can use, you can bring the cable back home and can, and then you can use it. Okay, but that's only for CN student lah. Okay, so I wouldn't want to talk too much about this because I think everybody have seen an Ethernet cable. So this is a cable that you use to connect your end devices to a network, a LAN network. Okay. So over here on the slides, you will see that you actually have a few different kind of Ethernet. Now, the first kind, which is the Ethernet, the standard Ethernet, it is the OTEC, okay? So in the early days when people started using this cable to connect devices, we start with the Ethernet connections. So Ethernet is not too fast. It can only go up to 10 meg per second, okay? It's go up to 10 meg per second. Okay, so if you want to go faster, then you have to use a fast Ethernet. With a fast Ethernet, you can go up to 100 meg per second. Okay, now if you want to go even faster, then you have to go up, go with the gigabit Ethernet, which give you 100 megabits per second. Okay, so actually this is their difference. It depends on how fast you want the network to be. Okay. And most of the time, I mean, these days, I think if you buy a new laptop or a new PC these days, it definitely should come with a gigabit Ethernet. This is the standard right now. Because if you are streaming, you want to stream on 4K, then fast Ethernet is just enough. It is able to support 4K, but just barely supporting 4K, okay? So if you want to future-proof your setup, your network, your laptop that you're going to buy for your degree, then at least make sure that you get a gigabit Ethernet connections lah. Okay, now that is for the cable. Okay, now this cable, there are also a few different kind of Ethernet cable. Okay, the one that I'm having here is a Cat 5 cable. It is also really it is fast enough to support gigabit Ethernet. But let's say if you want your connections to be more stable, okay, or maybe you have something that's even faster than gigabit Ethernet, then you can buy a newer version of this cable. These days we have Cat 6 and Cat 7e. Okay, so I think the one that you might have right now is actually a Cat 5 cable, but now we have Cat 6 and also Cat 7. Okay, so their difference would be like something like iPhone 11 Pro, iPhone 11 Pro Max. Okay, the higher the number, the better the quality of the cable is, and then you can support higher or faster transmission rate. Okay, that is for the RJ45 CAT cable. Okay, so I hope you are clear about all these kind of Ethernet connections and how they are different from each other. Okay, so now the next one, I'm going to show you a serial connections here. So this one is quite bulky. It is very big, and you don't normally get this cable from any shop lah. This one, it come with a router. Okay, so when you buy a new router, normally this one come together with the router. And the reason is because this cable, okay, I'm show you in this way. This cable here, you can also even see the two end is different. You have these two end here, so this is the end. Okay, you see you don't normally find this serial port on your PC or your laptop because this one is used to connect routers and routers, okay? So if you have two routers, then you want to connect them together, you will be using this cable, okay? So this is called a serial cable. Now in your lab, in one of your lab, you will also be using this serial cable to connect two routers together, okay? So if you want to have a closer look, this is it, okay? But I cannot go too close, otherwise you will see all my pores on the face. So this is the furthest that I can go. Okay, so this is the serial cable. Okay, I'll just do it here first. Okay, now let's get to the next one. The next one is a console connection. So we are talking about a console cable. Now this console cable is not the PlayStation 4, PlayStation 5 console cable. That is different, okay? That is the game console. This one is a console cable. So this one also normally you won't buy this anywhere. It also comes with a router. So the head is different. You can see the two sides of the head is different. So this one here is where you connect to the PC, okay? And this is where you connect to a router. So you might be asking, why do we need this cable? So this cable is used to connect a router to a PC, okay? Yeah? A PC means that I have something like this. This is a PC here. And then I connect this to a router. So if you want to do this one, you will use a console cable. Now, but this one is only used for management. Okay? So you see, normally when you connect your PC to a router, you will be using this cable. Because you want to get online, you want to go to the internet. So this cable is a data cable that allow you to go online. Okay? Now this cable is also used to connect PC to router, but it is not for us to go to the internet. This one is used for us to configure the router. So in this subject, you will be also learning about how to configure a Cisco router. Okay, so one of the lab you will use this cable. Okay, and you will know why we need to use this cable. The reason is because a router doesn't have a monitor, it doesn't have a display. So when you want to set anything on a router, you need to connect it to a PC for you to do the configuration. And this is the cable that you will use to connect the PC to the router. Okay, so this is the difference. This one is you use it when you want to go to the internet. You use this one when you want to configure the router. Okay, but both of these goes to the router. Okay. Now, after this one, we have the aux cable here. Okay, aux cable is something like this. I have one aux cable here. But this is not really important. This is just an aux cable. There are many, many different versions of aux cable. This is just one of it. And then you have this optical cable here. Now, this is the optical cable. Let me see if everything is fine. Okay, so this is the optical cable. This one is actually made by glass, so inside this is a glass. And when do we use this cable? You use this normally for connect to home theater or soundbar. So if you have all these speaker or any like entertainment devices, and how do you connect them together to get the audio signal? This is how you get it. So you have to be very careful with all the cables that is made with glass. Okay, so this one is one of example that is made with glass. Another one is the fiber cable. So all your UniFi right now, if you are using UniFi, the cable outside, not the one in your home, the one outside that is connected to your router is actually a fiber cable, which is also made with glass. So those cables are really fragile. You cannot bend them too much. If you bend too much, then it wouldn't work anymore. Okay, so those are glass cable. Okay, so I don't have a SPD here. I cannot show you an SPD, but basically those are the cables. Okay, yeah. Now let's go to the wireless connections here. So wireless, I think most of you are very familiar with wireless connections. Bluetooth, you connect to your wireless headphone, all this stuff using Bluetooth. Now for NFC, NFC is a near field communications. So it's something like Bluetooth, but you need to get very close. So for example, if I want to connect this thing to this device, okay? So this thing to this device, I just take this thing and then I put it near to him. Then ding ding, connected. So that is NFC for. What NFC is for? It means that it makes the connection to be seamless. So you just need to get near, then you can connect. And another example would be if you are using Samsung Pay or Apple Pay. So when you scan your Apple Watch or your Samsung Watch in the counter, okay, no need to take out your phone and then show touch and go, no need. Just scan, that's it. Okay, but you need to make sure you got money inside. Then the payment is done. So that is also contactless. And the way it is achieved is also using this NFC tag. Okay, this NFC. It stands for near field communications. Okay. Now, Wi-Fi Direct. How about Wi-Fi Direct? Okay, Wi-Fi Direct is a kind of wireless technology. It's something similar to the wireless connections that you're using right now. But it is mostly used for two devices. So it is not used for you to go to the internet. Instead, it is used for you to connect one device and two devices together. That is a Wi-Fi Direct. Now, in most cases, you'll be using a you're using Wi-Fi direct to connect to a wireless projector. So for example, if you buy a new PC today for your degree, okay, because you tell my mom, hey, mommy, I do programming, my lecturer say, if I don't buy a new PC, I cannot pass, can you buy me a new PC? Then most of the new PC these days are normally very slim, you have Ultrabooks, things like that. So they don't have enough clearance to add all these bulky display port, you know. So you see, the older laptop, you have HDMI, you have all these VGA, all these connector. So with all these new laptop, one of the way for you to connect to the projector when you want to do your presentation is you need to buy an adapter, okay? Another way is you can just use a Wi-Fi direct, which is why this Wi-Fi direct is for. Okay, this Wi-Fi direct, you can just connect your machine directly to a wireless projector, then you can start your presentation. Okay, so that is a different kind of wireless technology that you will have in most of the modern PC and Windows 10 machine. Okay. Okay, now the next one here is on cellular. Cellular means that all the communication that you see on a mobile device. So you have started, we started with 2G, 3G, and then now most of you, I think, is in a 4G coverage. Hopefully you are in a 4G coverage area. And with 4G, it is already fast enough for you to stream YouTube. Like if you're streaming from your data plan right now, you should be in 4G. And then you also have 5G coming up. So 5G is the latest one. I think you have heard of 5G. So we are going to have 5G very soon in next quarter, okay? I mean this year, next quarter. So last year, Maxis and Huawei, they already do the test run for 5G, and they get up to 3 gigabits per second of connection speed, which is really, really fast. So I think they started rolling out 5G, but most of the phone that we have these days don't support 5G yet, so we still cannot connect to the 5G network. So just to let you know, if you're going to buy a new phone, don't buy it right now, because in a very short while, you will see a lot of new phone coming up that come with 5G. So that's the best time for you to buy a new phone, not now. If you want to buy a new laptop for your degree, also not now, don't do it now. Because in 3 months time, AMD is going to launch a new processor, and I heard that Apple is going to move to the ARM processor. So if you want to buy anything, for Valentine, okay, for girlfriend, okay, buy rose, okay, but don't buy any new laptop or don't buy any new mobile phone for the time being, okay, because things is going to get really interesting in just a few months time, okay, yeah. So that is how wired and wireless is different from each other. Okay, so now if you're asking whether which one is better, is a wired connection better or a wireless connection better? Actually, I would say this is a draw, okay? Now, in 2 or 3 years back, if you ask this question, then definitely wired connection is better. Now, if you ask any gamer here, I'm sure most of you here are gamers, okay? And if you can choose, do you want to play your game using a wired connection or a wireless connection? Normally, people will say, no. Gamer don't want to play using wireless because even 10 millisecond lag can change the whole game. So, no wireless. But right now, it is almost the same. So for a wired connection, we want wired because it has lower latency, so the delay is not that noticeable. But with the new wireless tech, we have Wi-Fi 6 coming, okay? Wi-Fi 6 and also the 5G. With these two wireless tech, they actually cut down the latency up to 1 millisecond, okay? So actually, 1 millisecond is not noticeable if you play an online game, which means that in a very short while, we are all able to play online game, your Wangzhe, can play anywhere without any lag, because 1 millisecond, you know, is really, really so short and so fast that nobody is going to notice 1 millisecond of delay. Which is why, to go back to my question, wired and wireless, there isn't too much different anymore these days. Okay. So after this, I'm going to show you the network device. Just give me 1 minute, I'll go and get the network device, and then I will do an unboxing together with you right here. Okay, so just give me 1 minute and then come back in 1 minute time. Okay, guys. So I'm back with a router here. So what you are seeing here is a router. I'm not sure if I have enough time to show you all of the devices today. I'm going to show you at least a router. So if we don't have enough time, then we will continue on the next stream because I have another stream coming up for another batch of students. So over here, this is a Cisco router. I wanted to place the camera here so that you can see from top down, but I only have one camera. Anyway, can tell from the box, this is actually a good quality product, okay, real stuff. Even smell really good, you know. You cannot smell it there, but I can smell it from here. This box smell like chocolate. I can smell it like chocolate from here, so this must be good stuff. So let us see what we have in the box here. So, nothing much because this the cable that come with the box I already show you earlier, so we only have a router here. So let me take this out. I have to be very careful because this one is very expensive, okay? It is two months salary. So I don't want to hurt this guy here. Okay, so this is a Cisco router, a real enterprise router. So the first question now is, okay, I hope you can still hear me clearly. This one, first thing you'll notice is it is quite different from the router that you have in your home network, okay? So the one that you normally have is like TP-Link or D-Link, all those router. So those are also router, the same router, they do the same thing, okay, which is to forward packets. But those is for a home network, so it cannot support too much devices, and also it doesn't support different kind of configurations. But with this router here, this one, it costs up to 3K and or more. You can get inside this router and perform different kind of network configurations. Okay, so this is a Cisco router. You can tell it's actually a good start, you know. And later on, I will also show you a switch and then we see how it is different. So let's take a look at the back side of the router here. So over here you have four ports here. You can see clearly these four ports is where you connect the devices. So over here you see the orange color, the yellow color one, the F. Look at the yellow color one. So the yellow color one is where we put in the Ethernet cable. Okay, so this cable here. Actually, this router, all of the students will get one router to play with, but too bad this is an online class, so all of you are still going to get one router, but it is a virtual router on a software we call Packet Tracer, so this time you won't be able to touch this baby, okay? Anyway, I'll show you that this is where you put in the LAN cable, okay? So this one, and then you connect this end to a PC. Then you can get into the internet. Okay, so this is how a router works. I think you have the same thing in your home setup. You connect your PC using this Ethernet cable to one of the port that you have on your router. Okay, now after that, let's see what is the console for. Okay, now guys, look at this this one here, the blue color one. So this is the yellow one, this is the blue one. So the blue color one is where you put in the console cable. So remember just now we discussed about this cable. Okay, this one also connect to a PC, but it is not used to go to the internet, it is used to get into this router to do some configurations. So this cable here is going to get into this port here. So this console port here, can you see that? Okay, so this is how I connect on the router side. And then here, this one here will go to a PC. So of course you cannot use a PC without this port lah. If you are having a desktop, a gaming rig, then you check on your port. One of the port is this one. This is a console port, then you can connect, okay? If you are using a laptop, of course you wouldn't find this port on the back of your laptop lah. So you also need to find a machine that is able to connect to this cable. Then you can get inside and then you can do some configurations work, okay? And we'll learn about how to configure this router in one of the labs. So I for aux cable, I don't have it here, so I cannot show you. So actually, that's pretty much it lah. Okay, you have this one. This is the where you put in the LAN cables. This one is where you put in the console cable, and then this one is the serial connections. Okay, so this one is where you connect this blue color one. This blue color cable. This one here. Okay, so you can see here, this one here is for this. So I'm going to connect this one. So if I want to connect two routers together, I'll be connecting to this port here. Okay, do you get it? Now, thing of, I don't have enough time to show you the switch, so we'll stop here. And then I'll show the link to the next stream, and then I'll continue showing you all the networking devices that I have here in my office. And did I forget any cable? I think that's it, like most of the cable I've shown you. So yeah, this one no need to show you. This is a power cable. This is the most powerful cable. Without this cable, you cannot turn off anything. Okay, so this is the power cable. So guys, thank you for joining this stream today, and I will add the link for the next stream. So check back on Webber, and then we'll continue with this lecture. Okay, so thank you for joining, and see you soon. Peace out.